School teacher Irwin Abad is grieving for the many elementary school students who died in the powerful flash floods in northern Mindanao. But she's also concerned for the survivors. She turned to CBN disaster relief teams to comfort the traumatized students who escaped the tragedy.
I don't know how to comfort them during that time because I am also a victim of the flood. So I was not able to respond immediately, you know, to their side. That is why I asked some program just to give my students a hug.
15-year-old Jessime says she can still hear her father shouting instructions to her and her other family members as the floodwaters swept them away.
He said, "Child, hang on to the piece of wood and don't let go. Just cling to each other. My father was trying to help a paralyzed man, but the water was already high and the current was very strong. Until now, he is still missing. I want to see my father again."
Jessime barely made it. She was floating in the open sea, clinging to a piece of wood, when a boat rescued her the next morning. 17-year-old Herlin still complains of pain in her stomach because rescuers had to pump a lot of water from her body. She claims she was already dead when rescuers found her and brought her back to life.
"Our house was being swept with the flood water and I was trapped inside. I was rescued after an hour. I woke up and found myself lying in the street. I wanted to go back and look for my family, but I learned they are all safe. Thank God we are all alive."
CBN served lunch to Jessime, Herlin, and other students from Irwin School. CBN staff and volunteers listened to their stories and followed up with counseling, prayers, and much-needed hugs.
"Thank you very, very much. It is only once in a while that we can eat this kind of food. Most of the time, we eat spoiled food. But today, we were able to eat delicious food."
"Thank you to all of you. My brother and I are so full. We are happy to be able to eat, even if we don't have money."
The survivors were also given mats, fresh clothing, and slippers. Perhaps most importantly, they received comfort and hope to overcome difficulties in the days ahead. CBN has doubled relief efforts in the devastated areas, distributing food and other relief goods to thousands of affected families. Medical missions are also being conducted in evacuation centers. And to address the severe shortage of potable water, CBN has set up water purifiers in the area. In the months ahead, CBN will be there to provide for their physical, emotional, and spiritual rehabilitation. Charlene Israel, CBN News.